Hey, Roy Mark from Coast of the Country. Today's video, we're going to build a new fish cleaning table. I had one here which was basically whacked together in like an hour. That was 12 years ago, so it's done the job. It was made out of a bit of timber, threw a sink in it, had a bit of food grade stainless steel, and it was pretty rough. And we're just having a massive clean up at the moment. I've replaced the little veranda that I had over the old shed, made it bigger, and just tidying up a few things. This is the old fish cleaning station we had. Obviously that's normally on top. So this is a bit of the stand that we had. So the sink went in the top here, and then on the other end when it was standing up, this was all a bit of stainless steel, food grade stainless. And I used to fillet fish here and then drop them straight into the sink. So it's done its job for a while. It was whacked together in a big hurry, and I was intending on replacing it, but I never got around to it. So anyway, time to get rid of it, and we'll build a new one. I've got a heap of scrap metal lying around. I've had a huge clean out. This was all down the side of a shed at one point where you couldn't see it, but it was always handy to get a bit of scrap. I've now dragged it out. I'm sick of looking at it, and so I'm chopping up what I need, and the rest is all going to the scrapyard. What we've found, I've only got a certain amount of distance I can make this out of. So when the doors of this other shed open, they come right up to this little black line here. And so from, I've got two of there to the gutter here to make a table, which is about 1700 mil. So that's the room I've got to play with. This this post, which I've tidied up, was an old pipe rack. So it had bits of pipe sticking out, and you could actually run lengths of timber and pipe and storage on it. I don't use that anymore, so I've chopped off all the old pipe. So that frame's pretty solid. It's been concreted in, no worries. So what I'll do is build a bit of a table that bolts onto this, comes up, and so there'll be nothing underneath far as where, you know, mice and spiders and things can live. So we'll build a new table and we'll get into it. Right, so what we're doing is we're going to build this out of bits and pieces we've got lying around the shed. I had a spare sink that I was going to take up north mining with me, but that didn't happen, so it's just a secondhand sink I picked up. So that's going to be going in the top of the bench here. I've got some plywood left over from a job which wasn't quite big enough. It was one of the benches in my workshop that we used. So it's quite thick ply. What I've done, I already got a head start on this. I forgot to start recording. So anyway, what I've got is that distance that I said this whole table's got to fit within was 1700 mil. So what I've done is I've actually cut this down to 1685. I've had to cut this piece, and we're going to join that. We're going to biscuit join that together. I'll show you that in a minute. So 1685 is going to be the maximum length. And the only reason I've come up with that number is because the scrap metal I'm using as a frame for underneath this bench. So this is the top. Imagine this is going to be underneath later. This piece is 1600 long. So by the time I cut another couple of short bits of this and weld them on the ends, because these are 40 mil thick. So there'll be a box frame there, another 40 mil there. So that's why we ended up with 1680. So what I'll do is I'll have two of these down each side. Frame on the end, I'll put another beam, seal beam underneath where that join's going to be. Another beam here on the edge of where the sink's going to go. Already marked this out, so imagine this is obviously upside down. But I've got to cut out a section for where this sink goes. So there'll be another beam right along the edge there. So when that's up the other way, I'll have a big sheet of stainless steel again. So I can actually fillet fish here and then run them straight into the sink. I'll make a bit of a lip so there's nowhere where stuff like scales and guts and all that stuff gets stuck. So she'll be all nice and tidy, and we'll go from there. But yeah, so limits me a little bit what I can fillet. So basically I can't catch anything bigger than 640 mil, I should say. But anyway, some of my mates will say that's never going to happen anyway, so there you go. Right, this will make a bit more sense as we go along. But what we've done here, basically we've got our board laid out. We've allowed for 40 mil around the edge for where our framework's going to go underneath later. And then after that, we're going to put some stainless steel the whole way over here, obviously cut out around the sink, and it'll go over this front edge lip and underneath the steel frame as well. So there'll be a good spot for water to run off straight off there. So anyway, so I've got enough room for our frame, steel frame, 40 mil here we're going to have on the end. I've traced out the sink, so obviously it goes up the other way. So a sink's going to drop in here later. We've just got to cut out the holes where it's got to go. So what I need to do is cut out this inside line here all the way around. There's enough room to cut that at a 45, which gives it a bit more meat in the corners. That's how you normally install a sink into a kitchen anyway. So basically it's this line here. We're going to cut all this out all the way around on the inside, and the sink will drop in. And then what I'll do then, it'll make sense as we go. What I'll do then is I'll router out a little lip on the outside so the sink will set dead flush into this board, which I'll explain later. And then the stainless steel will go over the edge of that. So let's get cutting. Rightio, safety glasses on, earmuffs. Count your fingers, make sure they're all there, and then count them after and see if they're still there. Rightio, so I've done that little bit with the cordless circular saw. To finish these corners off, I'll just use this cordless jigsaw. Go fairly coarse. I'll give this one a try, see what happens. Rightio. Grab some glasses. All right, we'll just continue cutting the corners out of that. Doesn't have to be super accurate because it's going to be hidden with the sink anyway. It's just a cutout for where the sink drops into. Right, so that's pretty much cut out. Hopefully, that should just drop straight in there. Get these couple of clips out of the road. Right, so this is the underside. So if you were mounting this in a kitchen sink, laminated bench, obviously this is underneath. These flick in like that. That's your cutout. Everything's cleared. And you just screw these tabs down and they'll lock in tight like that, and that pulls your bench down nice and tight. But what we want to do with this, I want to make it flush mounted. I'll still use these clips later, but I want the lip of the sink to be dead flat with the top of the sink, so then I can put a piece of stainless steel over it. So clear as mud, I'll show you that and might make a bit of sense. All right, so what we've got here, this is a pretty much our bench. Obviously we're going to have this extra piece on the end here to get the length we need. Because this wasn't long enough, I'll chop this up for another job. I'm going to biscuit join that in a minute, so I'll show you a bit of that. So this is a bench. This will be the filleting part I'll use. The whole idea of making my own was I want to have it so the stainless steel comes down and a nice flat lip. So when you're skinning fish, you can actually tripping over stuff here. Right, so you can put your fish down here and you can actually run the knife on a flat edge. A lot of sinks have all got this sort of lip that comes down. So if you had a fillet there, you can't really get your knife flat on there. So I want to make this all stainless. This is a piece of stainless that I had from the other sink I had. So this was basically, you know, a bit of a different setup, but that was on there and I had the sink down that end. So I want to do the similar thing with this particular one. I'm going to do pretty much exactly that, but I'll come up the back here and I'll have a bit of a splashback on it as well. But what I want to do, I want to rebate this sink here and have that dead flush, same height from there to there, into that board. So then I can put this sheet of stainless on the top, and I'll cut out all around this profile here, all around. So when we're filleting, we can just slide fish straight off, like the waist, straight into the sink. No lips, nowhere for things to get sort of, you know, stuck on all these edges and things. Right, so what I need to do, in a nutshell, is basically router out this timber to the depth of this. So the top of that finishes with the top of that. All right, so I've cut out this lip here for where the sink drops in. I'm going to have to freehand cut out this radius on each end of the sink. And then I was thinking it really doesn't matter if I mess that up a bit anyway, because it's not going into a nice kitchen bench. It's going to get covered over with stainless steel over the edge of the lip of the thing anyway, so I could make a mess there. Thank goodness, because I made a... Whoop. And I'll just bash my way through here. Made a bit of a whoopsie there. Which doesn't matter, because once that sink's in flush, the stainless steel's going over that and will hide it. And that's the only difference between a good tradie and a bad one, is a good one can hide his mistakes. Okay, moment of truth. Not too bad. Actually, that's not bad at all. What's on that's clamped down. So that's what we're trying to achieve here. The height of that and the sink now level. So when I get a piece of stainless, that'll go right over there, and I'll cut out this profile edge here. And this will be all covered in stainless, and then the water can just run straight into that lip, and I'll sikaflex that in, because it is only a fish cleaning station, so that'll be good. Well, that worked out all right in the end. All right, we need to join this end piece on, a little bit of an extension, because this piece wasn't long enough. So we're going to use the biscuit joiner for that. And all that is a machine that, when that comes through, cuts out a little slot. And you can put the biscuits in the join. So you put these in between the two boards and they line up, and then that'll hold that together, and we'll glue and clamp that while I make the metal frame up. So what we have here, we've got our 20mm biscuits. So these will go in like this. I'm going to just use three of them to join this. Like I said, it's going to have stainless steel all over it, so it won't matter. There's going to be a beam underneath to take a bit of the load, and it's just a spot to fillet fish, so there's no real weight on it. So what we do is we grab our biscuit joiner, and as you push that through, a little blade comes out there and cuts a nice little circle which fits half of one of these discs. I've set it for 20mm, so that's pretty much right to go. And all I've done is mark the line, 100mm in each side, one in the centre. So we'll do three nice little cuts, spin this around, three cuts into here, stick our biscuits in and join that together. Right, just a matter of grabbing our biscuits now, putting them in. So hopefully one of these will fit. Oh no, that's the wrong type. Hang on. Oh, here we go. Right, so what we'll do, we'll glue these in. These are our little 20mm biscuits. Stick those in there. Whack that on like that. Line up our holes. Clamp that together with a bit of glue. And that's going to be stuck on there. And then I can start making the metal frame. Okay, we'll just glue this together. Okay, it's nice and level. So I'll let that set for a bit, and I'll start making this steel frame to go around the edge.
Time for a little house cleaning.